Hello everyone. In the process of learning a subject, the most important and first step is to read the lesson, isn't it? In school, teacher makes us to read the lesson once before explaining. But at home, for the students who find it difficult to read the lesson and for the differently abled, we are introducing audio textbooks. These will help you to listen and read the lesson while going through the text. Our state government has provided us with PDF of the textbooks. So let us start reading the lessons. Under extensive reading in our fourth unit is the lesson, The Emperor's New Clothes. Let's start reading the lesson. Many years ago, there was an emperor who was so fond of new clothes that he spent all his money on them. One day, two men came to the emperor's court. "We are weavers," they said. "We can make the most beautiful cloth in the world." The emperor was very happy. "Our cloth is also very special," said the men. "Only wise men can see it. Fools can't." "That's very good," thought the emperor. "When I wear the clothes made with it, I'll know who is wise and who is foolish." The emperor gave the men a lot of money. "Start weaving at once," he told them. They set up two looms and pretended to be very busy, though they had nothing at all on the looms. They asked for the finest silk and the purest gold thread. They put these in their own bags and they worked at the empty looms until late at night. "I should like to know how those weavers are getting on with my cloth," thought the emperor. "Only wise men can see the cloth. I'll send my old minister, who is the wisest man in the court." So the good old minister went into the room in which the men were working at the empty looms. "What can be the meaning of this?" thought the old man, opening his eyes very wide. "I cannot see anything on the looms." "Come a little nearer," said the men to the minister. "Isn't the cloth beautiful?" They pointed to the empty looms. The poor old minister looked hard. He could see nothing on the looms, for nothing was there. "What?" he thought. "Is it possible that I am a fool?" "Well, sir," said one of the men, "how do you like the cloth?" "Oh, it's splendid," said the minister. Now the emperor thought he would like to see the cloth. So he called his officers and went with them to the weaver's room. "Isn't the cloth beautiful?" said the old minister, pointing to the empty looms. "How is this?" said the emperor to himself. "I can see nothing at all. Am I a fool?" "Oh, it's beautiful," said the emperor aloud. All the officers looked keenly. They saw nothing on the looms. But they all said, "It's very beautiful." "For the great procession next week," said the old minister, "kindly wear robes made of this cloth." The emperor agreed. The weavers worked harder than ever. At last they said the cloth was ready. They cut in the air with a huge pair of scissors. They stitched the clothes with needles without any thread in them. "See," they cried at last, "the emperor's new clothes are ready." The emperor went to weavers with his officers. The weavers raised their arms in the air and said, "These are the trousers and this is the coat." "It's so light," said one of them. "You won't even feel the cloth," said the other. "That's the beauty of it," said one officer. "Yes," said all the others. "That's the beauty of it." But they couldn't see anything. There was nothing to see. "Will your majesty take off your clothes?" said the men. "Then you can put on your new clothes." The emperor took off all his clothes. The men made a show of putting new clothes on him. The emperor stood in front of a mirror and turned round and round. "How well his majesty looks in his new clothes," cried all his officers. Then the emperor walked along in the procession. People in the streets cried, how beautiful the emperor's new clothes are, but has got nothing on at all, said a little child. And one person said to the other, he has nothing on at all, he has nothing on. He has nothing on, cried all the people. The emperor felt unhappy. He knew that the people were right. He had nothing on, but the procession had to go on.
Please subscribe our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Thank you.